This, we're going to Cologne, Germany. The picture you see on the screen right now is the photo that Debbie Gastis, and I'm probably pronouncing her name incorrectly, shared with us and from Cologne, Germany. And she says, well, that's the view from her back window. Hi, Debbie. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Hi, Nicole. It's a pleasure.
Oh, it's great. And you sound great and you look great. And here we are connecting across the world. So you posted your message on Facebook with that photo. It was wonderful. You said, we do have a view from the front window, but I wanted to show you the view from my rear window because you said it's all about perspective and your perspective has changed since we've been or since you've been stuck in at home. Yes.
Absolutely. We have an apartment I love very much, but I've always been really upset about our balcony because it's very long, but very narrow, and you can't really do anything on it. We put a bench on there and we kind of have a barbecue out there, but it's not the kind of, well, we call it balcony. I think you guys call it porch or deck.
No, it's a balcony. That's a balcony. That yes,
yeah, exactly.
Porches and are usually...
You can't really do anything out there, and... I was always nagging about it, and I've come to pleasure it very, very much since we've been stuck here because we have the possibility, like around 11 o'clock, we have the perfect sun. It's especially in the really hot days, you have the, you know, when you have that first soft wind that kind of tells you it's going to be a really damn hot day, but you have a couple of minutes where the weather is just perfect. And I've learned that, well, not everybody has it, and it's a lot more than most people have, and I will never nag about this balcony again.
Right. You also said that you're in week six of self-isolation there in Germany, huh? That's, you know, where I've lost track of the time. I think this is about the fourth week we've been here. But you said you're in week six, and you also said, I'm going to quote you, you wrote, we're so very thankful for a balcony with morning sun where we can enjoy coffee in the morning. We have musicians in the neighborhood, so on some days we hear a clarinet and feel like we're in a New York Woody Allen movie. And another neighbor plays soft melodies on the piano that make me feel like I'm in a French romantic comedy. I love that you're bringing the world to you in this manner. It just sounds wonderful.
Yeah, I define my world mostly about noise or smell, actually. well, I'm a huge Woody Allen fan, and you know he plays a clarinet. And
yes.
We actually have a really... I still don't know who he is. I've been thinking about hanging out a sign to get in contact with him. And he practices. He's been doing it for years, actually, but I've never heard it as often as I do it nowadays. And in the house next to us, we live in sort of apartments with four floors. Yeah, we have somebody who plays piano and basically everything, from jazz to classic to rock to pop. I think it must be a professional musician, but it's beautiful.
That's
we
nice.
Enjoy that very much.
I'm not in such close quarters. I'm actually in South Florida, so it's already disgustingly hot and humid here. So all the, you know, the rumors that our president is pushing that, well, heat and humidity kill the virus. Obviously not, because you know it's 90 degrees here now or something ridiculous. Debbie Gastis, is this Gastis? Is that how I pronounce your name?
Percy, you pronounce it pretty good actually. It's Gastis.
Gastis. And you're in Cologne, Germany. Where is Cologne?
Cologne is pretty close to the border to Holland.
Ah, nice.
We're with the Rhine. The most famous thing about Cologne is the cathedral. And we are also national, worldwide famous for carnival.
Ah, well,
where people drink, kiss, and dance a whole week.
Yeah, none of that happening right now. So Germany has been on lockdown now or in isolation for about 6 weeks already. How's the spread there? How's the flattening of the curve?
The flattening of the curve at the moment is going very well. We've reduced it. I didn't know you were going to ask me the exact numbers.
Oh, no. Just, you know, generalizations.
We're really, really good, actually. It's going down, but it's a difficult situation because we are having the best, at least around here in Cologne, we are having the most amazing springtime since years.
Wow.
The sun has been out for weeks, which is not a typical thing in Cologne. And everything outside screams at you, come and have a beer in the beer garden, do this, do that. And everybody, I mean, you know, we have, I think that most people are behaving really good, but for the young people, it's really difficult. I mean, as a person who likes to refer to movies, in the sunshine, nothing bad can happen. That's why horror movies are in the dark or with the rain. Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes it really difficult. I think most are behaving really good. From Monday beginning, we have, I don't know the correct term, we have to wear masks.
Mm-hmm, we do too.
Everybody in Germany does. So at the moment, there's a huge hype about getting your personalized mask. Me and my husband have already ordered some as well, because you want to make a fashion thing out of it, of course.
Right.
I'm sure you heard about it. We had a big toilet paper crisis.
We did too. It was a global shortage of toilet paper.
Does anybody know where that comes from?
People hoarding. I guess they were afraid that, I don't know, that they'd run out of toilet. I don't understand.
That was my favorite post on Facebook. A friend of mine took a picture in a supermarket where the stock was full of toilet paper. And he said, I officially say crisis is over. Germany is saved again.
Yes, we have toilet paper in the stores now too. Go figure. We're still isolating. But all right, so Debbie, so what happens? I hope you don't mind me asking this question, but I'm truly curious about how healthcare works in countries other than the U.S. I don't know if you know about our system here, but we have a for-profit healthcare system, and that everybody needs insurance in order to get medical care.
You'd probably be surprised that how well informed the most Germans are about American healthcare system. It's a big subject over here.
Well,
too.
It's ridiculous, and now there's a giant spotlight shining on it because it's crazy. And we've had 26 million people in the last 5 weeks already file for unemployment benefits because they've lost their jobs because everything closed down. Well, unfortunately, here for most people, their health insurance comes from their employer. So that's 26 million more people who now probably don't have insurance, which is insane. Now, I don't know Germany's healthcare system, but I'm guessing, like the rest of the civilized world, that you have healthcare as a basic human right, don't you?
Absolutely, we do. And even a homeless person will come into a hospital and things will be done that need to be done to save his life. Of course, there are slight differences in the qualities. You know, if you have a private insurance, we all have one by the state. Sometimes I'm missing the terms. You have to have a health insurance.
Okay.
Yeah? And even if you own very little money, yeah, you can't get any extras, but everybody has basic insurance.
Exactly. As it should be. It's truly insane. And I would think that with this pandemic now bearing down on us, our leaders would get the message, but they haven't. Most countries are giving citizens some kind of a financial boost. I know Canada is giving $2,000 a month. I think Australia is giving citizens $1,000 a month. Other countries are giving a percentage of people's incomes while we're all stuck at home. Is Germany doing anything like that?
Well, we have the different. Well, the basic thing is that if you manage to get 365 days on your social social number, you know, where you pay in where. What we use to pay the taxes.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm kind of
social security.
Tax,
gotcha.
Yeah?
Right.
Then you have the right for 1 year of getting money when you're not working.
A year.
Wow. So the people have a basic saving. I mean, you know, you only get 60% from your earnings. So of course it's a cut down. We have programs for artists because I personally come also from the TV business.
Yes.
And of course for us it's been a hard hit because I do shows and with no audience, comedy just does not work. We tried, I tell you, we really tried. It does not work. So of course that's a problem. I really don't want to say that we're solving it all, but what I see is that everybody is making a real effort. I think they're handling it really well. Angela is hitting out a lot of money for everybody. It's never going to be enough to make everybody happy. That's the way I see it. But for example, on Facebook, there was, I think, after the first day when everybody had to stop the jobs in the TV studios, there was a group from German TV people. And a lot of them, we have two ways of working in Germany. You can either invoice, yeah, and mm-hmm. then you have to take care of your own taxes, your own insurance, and you don't pay out of work insurance. Yeah, so that means if you lose your job and you've always invoiced, you didn't pay the out of work insurance, then you have a problem as well. But some of these jobs acquire this kind of work. It has something to do with the artistic side of you. And they're really trying to have funds where you can get very quick help. You can describe, this is my business, this is why I'm not making money. Of course, you have to do some paperwork. Mm-hmm. But I know a lot of people who have already received this money. And again, it's never going to be enough. But yes, they're making a real effort.
That's great.
To be a German person at the moment. I'm very thankful for living here, because I really feel that our politicians are doing their very, very best. Hmm. It's very easy to criticize somebody. Well, it's not as easy as criticizing Trump, to be honest.
No, you can criticize Trump all you want. Bring it on.
I know. But once I get started, this is going to take an hour. but I'm really happy how Angela is handling it. She has a science background, and I think that's our greatest luck, because that's why she listens to the recommendations of intelligent people. Mm. She listens to them, and I'm really having a blackout with some words.
That's okay.
The economy, of course, is not happy about what's happening. But the other question is, if we do what's good for the economy, what's happening with the people? Are we going to survive this, or is this really going to bring us in a dump? And at the moment, I'm pleased that she is putting science first in her decision making.
That is, I wish we had that here. Unfortunately, as you know, we have this madman in the White House. And did you hear the latest last night or yesterday?
Yes, we did. Believe him, in Germany, Trump, for people who are politically interested, and I think by now even for people who are not, it's like a drug. You have to watch Trump news. And most of the time, well, at first we laughed.
Right.
Sometimes now I'm just really, really scared.
Yes.
Because, yes, he's mad.
He is mad. He there is a problem there, and he lies incessantly, and it's just so frustrating.
You know, since Trump is there, I understand German history better, because you know, my generation of course says, "Hey, how could that with Hitler happen?"
Right.
Well, maybe he's not a Hitler, but
he's close.
He's exactly as bad as an example for what he does in his country.
And a lot of his followers are carrying around Nazi flags. It's really frightening, and somebody Jewish by heritage, it's even more frightening. I mean, just it's incredible. And he thinks there are very fine people on all sides. It is frightening.
My grandmother is twirling in her urn. I mean, I cannot describe how sometimes in Germany, when we sit here with friends and we watch the news and we see the latest bullshit he's been talking, we kind of think, is it impossible? It's impossible that not everybody can see this. How can it be that he might be voted for again?
Well, we're hoping. I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Now, I'm not the biggest Joe Biden fan, but as I say all the time, my dog Jackson would be a better president than Donald Trump. So we're going there.
I agree, and I don't even know Jackson.
and he's goofy and crazy and neurotic, but he'd still be a better president than Donald Trump. So, Debbie, just in the moment we have left, what you work in television, what kind of show do you work on? What do you do?
I think you call it a line producer. I'm basically responsible for finances and organizations for a German production company. And we kind of produce for all kind of networks. And we are specialized on comedy shows and quiz shows.
Wow. Very nice. Well, hopefully I'd love to see one of your shows one of these days, but I don't speak German, so it probably would go right over my head or something. Anyway, Debbie Gastis, I'm so happy. I'm so happy I found this Facebook group, because I'm not a big fan of Facebook either.
But
it really is. So once again, for those watching on YouTube, I'll put up the picture that you show. It's a view from your back balcony in Cologne, Germany, where you write, you said, "This page is my new addiction, and together with the music in my backyard, a gin tonic, I can travel the world in my dreams. Stay home, take care, and be optimistic, because it really is a question of perspective." Debbie, what a pleasure it was talking to you. Thank you so much for spending some time with us today.
Thank you very much as well. It was a pleasure for me too, and good luck for everything that's to come.
Oh, thank you so much. The same to you. Stay safe.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Take care. Bye.
You too.